Hi everyone, I am Suman. In this video, we will discuss the advantages of NumPy array over list. So, we just have three main advantages. First, the array consumes less memory when compared to list. And second thing is fast, right? The array is much faster than a list. And third one is we can able to perform some operations, right? Mathematical operations very easily when compared to this. A list. So let's see these three advantages one by one. So first one is NumPy array uses a less memory. So yeah, let's see with example, like whether it's using less memory or more memory. So let's see that. So for that, I will just create a list. So you can see I just create a list, LIS is equal to, and I will just use a list of. And instead of creating that manually, I will just use this range of function, range of 100, right? I will just creating a list of 100 values. So if I just print this list, so you can see this is from 0 to 99, right? So similarly, let's create an array also. So I will just use arr is equal to and np dot, we just have arrange function, right? In order to create an array. So here I'm just using arrange function, and similarly I just give some 100 values. So you can see if I just print this, so even here we just got 100 values, but this is of array, right? So yeah, we just created array and list. Now let's see how much memory both are taking. First let's see a list, right? So for that, so you have to calculate the element, like how much memory it is taking. First let's calculate in a list how much memory and each element is taking. So first we will just calculate that, then we will just multiply with number of elements in the list. So for that, so let's import another module, import sys here, and first let's get the size of one element in an array, like in the list. So this dot get size of, so this is a function, get size of function. It will just give you a size of object which you passed in that. It will just give you how many bytes it just taken. So I'll just give one here. So you can see, and one element has taken 28 bytes, right? In lists, it just taking 28 bytes to store this one. Now let's multiply this with total elements in the list, right? So the total number of elements is 100. So we just give len of LIS. So you can see in total the list has taken 2800 bytes, right? Similarly, let's calculate with array. So in order to calculate the size of elements in array, so we just have in the array itself, we just have some basic functions. So let's use that. So let's use arr dot, so item size, we just have item size, right? So if I just give enter, you can see like each element in array is just taking 4 bytes to store. So you can see in list we just seen it's just taking 28 bytes, in array it's just taking only 4 bytes, right? So that you can see clear difference here. So let's multiply this with total elements in the array, right? So arr dot, we just have size, right? So you can see, so we just multiplied, this array is 100, right? So we can see 4 into 100, it's just taking 400 bytes. You can see the clear difference here. So the list has taken 2800 bytes, and array is just taking 400 bytes. So this is just with a list with 100 values. So for example, if you just take millions of record, right? So in that case, it will just create a huge impact, right? So that's the reason we just want to use array. So now let's talk, like, what's the reason for this? Like, why this array is taking less memory and why the list is consuming more memory? So we actually know, right? Python is an object-oriented programming language. So everything, whatever it may be, integer, float, everything it just stores in object format. So if you can see the memory representation of list here, So we used to have, you can see we just have pointers, and these pointers are locating to the memory, right? It's just referring to the memory, right? So that's how these elements are stored in a list. So you can see it's not storing the elements in an order. So if you can see the array, it just stores the elements in a contiguous memory location. In the sense, it just stores in an order, right? So in the first memory location, it just have 0. So you can see if you just take this array, we just have 0 to 199, right? So in the first memory location, it just stores 0, and in second memory location, it just stores 1, right? So if we just stores in this manner, we don't want pointers to refer to some memory location. So since we just have elements in the order, so we can able to easily extract the values, right? So that's an advantage of using array. So that's the reason why array is taking less memory. So you can see the memory representation also. So since we just have these objects and we are just using the pointers to locate, to reference, to refer to these objects, so that's the reason why this list is taking more memory when compared to array. So I hope you got this. And second thing is, array is fast when compared to list. So let's see this also with example. So here we just have list, right? Similarly, I'll just create an other list also. So I'll just use list 1 is equal to range of 100, and similarly list 2 is equal to list of range of, so you can see I just created two lists. And similarly I'll just create two arrays also, and here we just have already array, right? So I'll just copy this. Array 1 is equal to np dot arrange of 100, and array 2 is equal to np dot we'll just give 100 to 200, right? So we just have two lists and two arrays. Now let's perform addition operation on both these things. So let's see which is computing very fast. So now let's see that. So I will just use, so you know, if you want to add two lists, so what we have to do, we just want to add these two, right? So let's give I plus j for I comma j in zip of list 1 comma list 2, right? So what it will do means, first it will just take elements one by one from these two, right? From these two lists, it just takes element one by one, and it will just add this. So it will just add those two elements, and it will just create a list. Accordingly, it will just create a list. So we are just performing element wise addition operation. So if I just give, so before running this, so let's get the time here. So let's use the time module. So time dot time off. So we just have, this is the time module, and in this time module we just have time function. So I'm just using that, and this is the start, right? This is the starting time, and similarly let's calculate the end, right? Time dot time off, and print end minus start, right? So now let's run this. So yeah, we don't have time module, right? So let's import that. So you can see just showing 0 seconds. So let's take some high values, like more number of values in this. So you can see I'm just taking 10 million records, right? So similarly, I'll just take 10 million records for array also. Now if I just calculate, right? So you can see it just taken 2.23 seconds to calculate this, to perform this operation. Now if you just check the array, right? So you can see the array has taken only 0.35 seconds. So you can see the clear difference, right? You can see the clear difference in this. So yeah, so the reason behind that is, so we have already know, right? why we are just using result is equal to both, we are just instead of taking element by element, and instead of adding those, we are just adding those two arrays itself. So why? Because the arrays are storing the elements in contiguous memory location. So directly we can able to, since they are in order, we can able to direct, we can directly take first element in one array and similarly the first element in second array, we can able to add those two. But when it comes to list, since they are not in order, so since we just want to do this for loop and we just want to add those things, so it's just taking more time, right? So that's the reason. So this is one advantage, you can see the clear difference here. And the third advantage of using array is we can able to perform mathematical operations, right? So if you can see, even here you can just see, right? So if you want to add those two elements in the list, you just want to do you want to loop through those, and you just want to add those things, right? So here you can see, when it comes to array, we can able to add directly. And similarly, right, we can see when it comes to array, we just have a lot of functions, right? You know, if you want to add the total values, like if you want to get the each item size, right? So you can see, even like what we did in the previous case, when we are just want to get the element, like if you want to get the size, we just imported some other module and we just got the size, right? So when it comes to array, even this array itself, we just have a lot of modules, like a lot of functions, and you can see we just able to perform mean, and you can see we just able to do all those things, right? So we can able to perform a lot of mathematical operations, so in an easy manner. So yeah, that's the difference in list and array. So these are the advantages of array over list. So yeah, apart from this, we just have a lot of other advantages, but these are the three main advantages we just have in this. So you can see, yeah, you can see how much memory it's just consuming and how much time it's just consuming. So when it comes to some big applications, right, when it comes to deep learning, we used to have a lot of data, right? So when we have a lot of data, then so you can see, even in these few records itself, it's just showing lot of difference, right? So when it comes to that, when we are just showing that much amount of data, so it will just create a huge difference. So yeah, I hope you got an idea of advantages of array over list. So that's it for this video. If you feel this video is helpful, like the video, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please subscribe. And if you have anything to say or if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section, and thanks for watching.